Hello, I'm Gary Collins. Welcome to our magazine. America's top expert on household hints, Heloise, has appeared on our show many times, and as you probably know, her hair is one of her trademarks. Today, Jose Ibert is going to change that as he performs one of his magic makeovers on none other than Heloise. Here's Bonnie.
I'm Bonnie Strauss. Many people feel as they grow older, their sexuality fades. Alexandra Penney is going to join me later to talk about some of the ways to keep love alive as she discusses sexuality after 50.
And in just a moment, you're going to meet the Rader House quadruplets, who are patiently waiting upstairs in the Our Magazine nursery, and we're going to find out about their miracle birth. Four of them were born 10 and a half weeks premature, and they range from 2 pounds, 9 ounces to 3 pounds. All this and a lot more on today's edition of Our Magazine. Introduce you to four very special young people. This is Jeff, Kate, Keith, and Eric, respectively. Now, in case you haven't figured it all out, these beautiful babies are quadruplets. They were born to Janet and Scott Rader House on November the 21st, 1983, and what makes them particularly special is that 1 year before, Janet had lost another set of quadruplets, born prematurely and unable to survive. But as you just saw, this is a story with a happy ending, or I should say, happy beginning. Would you please welcome two very proud parents, Janet and Scott Rader House. I can only imagine how happy you must have been when these children were born healthy, had all their fingers and all their toes, and everything was okay. Can you describe the experience?
Well, after months and months of laying on my back and worrying about the babies, their health and everything, when they were born, we just couldn't wait to hear their screams.
Yeah.
You know, and that was a good indication that they were might be doing okay.
Yeah. Now, Scott, you're a physician, am I correct?
Yes, that's right.
And you were you there during the delivery?
Yeah, I was able to take video movies of the whole thing.
Oh, my gosh. Was this a natural childbirth?
Or
do you do that with four?
No. This is a planned C-section.
Yeah. Okay. Now, had you had an infertility problem and were taking the fertility drugs?
Yeah, for 2 years, we were unable to conceive, so I went to the fertility specialist, and we tried different things, and we were able to conceive quite quickly on the drug that mm-hmm. we were given.
Now, was that the first time around?
Yeah, the first time and the second time, too.
Yeah, now what happened with the first set of quads?
Well, I went into premature labor, and my water bag broke.
Mm-hmm.
And so we had to deliver the babies. They're only 24 weeks along, so, you know, there's nothing we could do to prolong their lives or anything.
This is a strange question, but is the sorrow multiplied, or is there a... How do you cope with four? I mean, is it people... lose one during pregnancy. How do you cope with four? Coping with one is a devastation.
Well, everything just happened so fast because, between the time I broke my water bag broke and we delivered, it was just a matter of hours, and we knew they were all going to die, and we had to go through the whole thing of the delivery. They were delivered vaginally,
mm-hmm.
and, then we were waiting for each one to die, and it was a very hard thing on us. But, it was and it happened on Christmas morning, so it was something that will always be with us. But then now we have the other four to sort of help us through.
You're a pediatric nurse?
Yeah.
And you being a physician, did that help any in dealing and coping with it?
Well, it helps make, I think, decisions about how far you can go. We realized that they were only 24 weeks and there was no chance that they were going to survive.
I see.
And we just figured that why try to prolong things,
mm-hmm.
and we just let them die.
But it was hard as parents, I think,
them
do that, we knew medically what should be done and what shouldn't be done.
Is there any downside, is there any risk at all to any effects from the fertility drugs? Do we know, have we done enough studies and followed up enough couples? I'm not sure how long it's been used.
The particular drug that Janet was on is called Perginal,
mm-hmm.
and it's probably less commonly known than the other drug, Clomid, but Perginal has an increased chance of multiple births, and also some other additional problems, uterine rupture and so on.
Anything to the children, or is that... Or...
No, the children has no effect, mm-hmm. apart from being multiple and having additional risks there.
Yeah, are you going to take the drug anymore?
Yeah, no, I've did my share. We've done our...
Well, how do you... The obvious question is, how do you cope with four at the same time? How do you do it? How do you feed them? I mean, you... Am I correct? You came up with an invention?
Yeah, I have it here if you'd like to
see
it.
Yeah, I'd love to see it. I have no idea what this is, but
well,
I get an idea. There's a bottle hanging there.
After our first couple of weeks at home, they were on a three-hour feeding schedule, and it took 2 hours to feed them. And so we had an hour interval in between feedings. And so after a bit of time, we weren't quite sure how we were going to handle this. So I was thinking of ways to feed them automatically. And some developmentalists might disfavor this idea, but nonetheless, it helps the feeding, and we can cut the feeding time down from 2 hours to 45 minutes. And what we do is have the bottle attached by Velcro, and it fits in the baby's mouth. And I have three of these things made so that I can feed three at a time while Janet feeds Jeff, and he can't eat quite as well as the other three. Mm-hmm. So, and then I just pull them out when I need to burp them, and you have to keep an eye on them so they don't throw up in their face.
Oh, and it's just soft. It's terrific. Well, do you, I mean, can you breastfeed? Was that ever an option
to supplement?
I tried to
at the beginning when they were in the hospital. I had to pump my breast, and they got breast milk for 9 months, for 9 weeks.
Oh, they did.
And then when I sent them all home in the matter of in 4 days, it was just too much because they weren't sucking very well. They were premature babies, uh-huh. and they got so used to the nipple. The bottle.
Yes.
That I just said my sleep was a little more important and their nutrition was the most important with it.
Well, I think it's time to meet the quads, and I hear them fast approaching. Come on in. Eric, Kate,
Keith,
and Jeff. Come on in, kids. Well, actually, the kids aren't walking in. There's somebody helping. Are these grandparents?
No, I was two.
Two grandparents. Well, it's nice to have you here. Oh, I better take one.
Would you like me?
Yes, thank you. Who do I have?
This is Kate.
You're real good about this,
Yeah, they look, yeah.
We got three boys and one girl. Oh, look at that. Well, hi, Snuggums. How you doing? Huh? Well, tell me something.
You're not getting away that free.
Oh,
okay. Tell me something, Scott. Have you started the college fund yet? This is going to be murder on you, you know.
Trade school's the answer.
Trade school? Good grief. Well, now, how... You know, feeding is one thing, but what happens to the rest of your day? Do you have help?
Well, we have the help of friends that offer, but we more or less do it ourselves.
Well, I don't know where it went. Where'd it go?
Here we go.
Oh. No, give me one. Yeah. Well, Janet, Scott, and you four, I want to thank y'all for being here. And I want to follow your progress. And before you leave, I do have something I want you to take with you. Oh. All right, okay. All right.
Oh.
If you'll take that youngin.
Was this it?
All right. Ah, there. I have this right back here. And these are something for the little girl and something for the little boys.
Oh.
Thank you both very, very much. In a moment, Bonnie Strauss finds out how to keep sexuality alive after 50, right after this.
Next, a woman returns the engagement ring she bought.
I said, I do not care to buy any jewelry. I'd prefer the cash. And he said, I will pay you in cash at the time that I resell the ring.
But the defendant's wife has evidence to the contrary.
It says no cash refunds unless agreed to in writing, Your Honor. And this is on all of our receipts, even on her original one. We do not give cash refunds, Your Honor.
I don't believe it's on my copy of the receipt.
Tuesday at 5 on TV2. For exceptional value,
check us out.
Hills discounts everything every day. But when we can offer you ladies Lee jeans for $17.97, we call that an exceptional value.
Check us out.
$17.97 for misses and junior sizes, proportioned in petite and average lengths. $17.97.
Check us out.
Now that's a price you won't see every day, unless you go to Hills. No need to wait for a sale, ever.
Check us out.
Sunup has never had caffeine. It was followed by these soft drinks with no caffeine.
Have I got news for them? Sunup also has no artificial color.
These are artificially colored.
And Sunup has no artificial flavor. No wonder Sunup has such a clean, refreshing, unspoiled taste.
wonder 7-Up has such a following.
7-Up. Senior prom, 20 years and 20 pounds ago. Oh.
Hey, Peggy, Thrift Drug can help. We've got Dexatrim on sale, the diet aid recommended most by pharmacists. It helps control your appetite so you eat less and lose weight. And with your $1 manufacturer's rebate, your final cost is just $1.79. Hey, Peggy, you still look great. For a trim Dexatrim you at a slimmer price, trust Thrift Drug.
These days, thanks to better nutrition, exercise, and medical care, men and women are maintaining their health and living longer lives. And that seems to be raising a lot of issues, including the area of sexuality. Today, Bonnie Strauss discusses this often ignored subject. Bonnie?
Well, Gary, many people don't think that sex is compatible with aging, and that perhaps age inhibits many older people from feeling free to sexually express themselves. Well, here to discuss some common concerns is journalist Alexandra Penney, the author of How to Make Love to Each Other. She's going to share her insights with us. I think so often that people have a really difficult time thinking about older people making love.
Well, Bonnie, it's because we're a youth-oriented society, but no more. People are getting older, and sexuality is a big issue.
Well, older people today obviously do make love. They probably have always made love, although some research indicates that there's almost like a sexual revolution going on.
There is a sexual revolution going on. Sexuality as we get older continues is terrific. We're sexual beings from the time we're born until the time we die. And what is terrific is that we're beginning to acknowledge that men and women can have wonderful, meaningful physical bonding for as long as they continue to be healthy and active.
The sexual revolution, obviously, we know affects a lot of young people, but the fact that it is something that older people, I think it was Consumers Union, it was indicated
yes.
that it is going on with people over 60
yes.
and 70.
And 80 and even on.
Well, now that we have that information, though, and with society still being somewhat hesitant to think about older people making love, does it inhibit the older people? Do they feel they have to almost keep it to themselves?
Up until now, we've had this kind of being in the closet sexually with people, say, in their 50s, 60s, and 70s. But with the population really going toward an older area, we now have a much more emphasized sexuality, and people feel great, again, about being physical and showing their physicality.
Some studies indicate that sex gets better for women as they get older.
Well, this may have to do with physical phenomena, both for men and for women. After about the age of 50 or so, we go through menopause, and we don't have the fear of pregnancy, so that a lot of the anxieties and fears are alleviated. And many women that I've interviewed and many that other sexual experts have talked with say that they feel great when they're older and they have a much more easy, more understanding sexual life, and they're also more skillful.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, though, the physical changes do catch up with us. What are some of those that we have to learn to overcome in order to keep closely connected sexually?
Well, yes and no, they do and they don't. Men slow down, their arousal rates slow down somewhere after 50. But this can be good news because they're slower. Timing is more in tune with a woman's timing, which is biologically slower. Mm-hmm. So you have a situation where nature really gets people closer together. What's interesting is that we can be sexually active throughout all our lives, and this is where the new research is pinpointing.
Mm-hmm. Speaking and getting back to physical things, so the fear of impotency, how great is that?
This is enormous, and what impotence is all about is self-perpetuating. If a man fears that, say, he's going to slow down or he's going to be, we're talking about temporary impotence here as differentiated from more long-standing kind. If he feels that he is going to be impotent because he's getting older, that fear can perpetuate itself. There will be times when he does perhaps have an occasional temporary impotence. There's a great deal that women can do to help a man with this, a lot of which has to do with relaxing, taking the focus off performance. And young people have the same problems in that same area.
I heard that if you were sexually active when you're young, and meaning from 20 to 40, that usually is the pattern in older age as well.
That's where the great news is. The more you do it, the better it's going to be as you get older. And I mean this quite seriously.
Our audience as likes that.
As we are sexually active, we keep up the sexual activity, and there is no reason why we can't have, it's like exercising. If you keep exercising, you feel terrific, you look terrific. Mm. Same with sexuality.
Mm. What about the issue of keeping the passion alive so that after so many years, you still want to be together?
That's a big, big area, and that can be the bedroom blahs, and it hits all of us sometimes, young and old, but it's harder as you get older. First of all, don't do the same thing twice. Don't make love in the same place every time. Why not light some candles? Try something new. Novelty is great, romance. Seduce your husband. Tell him I'm going to plan a terrific weekend for you. I listen to people laughing, but it's a real serious issue, romance.
Why do you think they're laughing?
I think they may be uncomfortable with it. It's the same attitude that we have about sexuality as we age. Sex is terrific. It's love. It's physical bonding. It feels great. Why not enjoy that pleasure? One of the wonderful things about sexual aging is that we continue to be unimpaired. Sexuality continues, and that, I think, is the best news I can report right now.
I think sometimes it seems that people get really hung up on the frequency of sex and actually even defining sex. Sex is not the same thing to everyone.
You're making a wonderful point. Sex does not have to mean intercourse every time. There's a whole area and spectrum of sexuality that we can experiment with that can be very satisfying for both men and women, again, as they grow older. There's a lot more time and room for experimentation. Keep an open mind, I think, is the biggest thing.
Well, but if one loses interest and the other remains very interested in sex, that's a delicate negotiation to come to the same level, I think, of need.
You're talking there about communication and love negotiations. It's something that I do bring out in the book that I've just written. But it has to do with saying what you really want, saying, listen, I would still like to have a very active sexual life, what you're willing to settle for, okay, maybe not five times a week, maybe two, or it's unacceptable to me not to have a sexual life. So both partners must ask those three questions. What do I really want? What can I live with? Mm-hmm. What's unacceptable? And you begin, as you said, to negotiate an agreement between yourself. It might sound like business-like, but it's a technique sexual therapists use with great results.
You've interviewed so many people. What are some of the common myths that you've encountered in terms of the older person?
The older person thinks, I'm going to be impotent, I'm going to slow down, sex is not going to be better, I'm going to be embarrassed, people are going to laugh at me if I'm sexual. All of a sudden, these myths have come up into the fore in the media, and one of the wonderful things is that we're smashing these myths. The other thing is that the physicality does change, but the changes are not necessarily for the worse. We always think of old age as slowing down and just becoming really decrepit, but we were talking about exercise and nutrition. There's no reason why a healthy person can't have a wonderful physical pleasuring with their partner.
You have so much information, and it's always wonderful to have you here, and there's a lot of a reason to have optimism, you know, as we get older, and I think that's one of the things we have to continually reinforce.
You just hit it. I think we always look forward to getting older as something that's going to be depressing or downward. Today's new research is pointing to a whole lot of much more exciting information as we all get older.
Great. Thanks for being with us. We'll be back in just a moment.
Single, divorced, widowed, alone, had it with the single scene, the bars, the boredom, the loneliness, still searching for that certain someone? Matchmaker is a personal dating service. Why not let us be your matchmaker? Why be alone?
279-5500. That's 279-5500 for Matchmaker.
Dare to be a maiden form woman. Buy two seamless bras and save $5. It's the maiden form dream of a seamless sale.
Ray Tannehill. He's been there with Khrushchev, Kennedy, Carter, Reagan. He's seen disaster in Honduras, been on the scene in war-torn Beirut.
Things really haven't changed that much. Still only one way to grab a story. You gotta be there, it's as simple as that.
Ray Tannehill is a working newsman at K. KDKA-TV, we think there's a whole lot more to the news than just talking to you behind a desk.
For most luggage, travel can become a real torture test. And for soft-sided luggage to survive, it must be as durable as it is lightweight. To survive, it must be rugged. In the way it's designed, in the way it's made. That's why more people travel with Samsonite. Because when you survive the trip, so should your luggage. Samsonite, the survivor.
The book that hit America like a runaway locomotive. From the Consumer Information Center of the U.S. government. More than 200 fact-filled federal publications listed inside. And it's free. Write to New Catalog, Pueblo, Colorado, 81009. Don't wait for the movie.
My next guest does it all. He sings, he dances, and he's the latest addition to the television show Gimme a Break, where he plays pint-sized con artist Joey Donovan. But when it comes to talent, there's absolutely nothing deceiving about this 7-year-old. And if you don't believe me, you will in a moment. Would you please welcome Joey Lawrence?
Where is love? Does it fall from skies above? Is it underneath the willow tree that I've been dreaming of? Where is she?
Was terrific.
Thanks.
Now, tell me, where'd you discover that you could sing? In the shower or what? Huh?
When I was 2, I started singing Staying Alive, and then from then on, I just kept singing, and then now I'm singing.
Yeah. How'd you get into Gimme a Break? Was that a tough situation? Did you have to audition with a lot of people?
No. You know how I really got in?
Was, yeah, I would like to know, yeah.
Okay, well, they didn't audition me or anything. They said, we want this Joey Lawrence.
I still have to audition. You didn't have to audition?
Nah.
See, that's how I got this job. I had to audition.
Oh.
Yeah, well, they had seen you do something then, huh? Or they
yeah,
knew
they
about
saw
you.
Me. I was on the Johnny Carson show.
Oh, I see. Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah.
It was supposed to be a terrific evening, huh?
Yeah.
When you're hot, right? I understand that you dance a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, break dancing. That's that stuff that the guys do where they roll around and Michael Jackson does where they moonwalk and all of that stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, do you do that?
A little.
A little. What, are you learning how to do it now?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know you're a terrific tap dancer and maybe you...
I can't do the spin on my back yet.
Yeah.
That's what I'm learning.
Well, if you got to save something for later, that's a good item to save. Well, can you give me an example of this break dancing and the moonwalk?
Sure.
Okay. All right. What do you have to do?
The first thing you have... Okay, I'm going to teach you the wave.
The wave, all right.
Yeah. Okay, the first thing you have to do is bend your finger.
Yeah.
And then you put... And then you close your fingers to a fist.
Yeah.
Then you put your finger down like this.
Okay.
Then you put your fingers, and then you put your elbow up.
Yeah.
And then you bring it up, and you bring it out, and you bring it out, and you bring it out.
Oh, and then you just do that over and over again on each side, huh?
Well, just, well, on the to learn easy, just keep doing it on that side.
Yeah, should I bring my arm down?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, okay. All right, and then what's the next part we have to do?
And the next part is the moonwalk.
Yeah.
And how you do that is stand like me.
Okay.
Okay, then you have to put this foot back, and then put this one at a... Push this one back.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
Oh, good. Oh, oh, I. Oh.
See,
oh, hey, just... Mom, look at this.
Yeah.
Okay, now.
Yeah.
All right, we need a little music, don't we?
Yeah.
Okay, Glenn, can we have a little music? We're gonna. Okay. I don't understand. What? We're in a telethon here. Oh, it's sitting down. See, you left me in the dark there. I just can't. You know what's. Enough, Glenn. I'll never get this. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to start Saturday, this coming Saturday. I'm going to take tap dancing lessons. Yes, you have shamed me. I promise
you. Good luck.
I mean, we'll work with my right leg Saturday, and then next Saturday we'll work with my left.
Yeah.
Are you trying to teach anybody else in your family this?
Yeah, this.
Yeah, who?
My mom and my dad and my brother.
Yeah? Are they any better than I am?
No, not really.
Oh, that's good. I feel a lot better.
Yeah.
You've also got a brother, right?
Yeah.
How old is he, four?
Four, yeah. He just turned four Saturday.
Yeah, is he going to be like you? Is he going to go into showbiz?
Yeah, that's what he wants to do.
Oh, he does. He's singing? Yeah. Does he also dance?
Yeah, he, you know, he does the wave pretty good.
Yeah. Well, listen, I know you're a terrific tap dancer. Could you give us a little example?
Sure.
Okay. You, I want to do that more than anything. How long did it take you to do that? Oh, huh?
About 3 or 4 months.
3 or 4 months?
Yeah, something like that.
Now, what advice would you have for some youngster that's out there watching, or a mom that's watching, and they want to get their youngster into television?
Well, I got it. Well, this is how I got into television.
Yeah.
Well, a lady saw me in the supermarket. And when I was with my mom and my brother was not even born.
Yeah.
And she said, this kid should go to New York. So I went to New York.
Just because this lady in the supermarket told you?
Yeah.
Well, actually, you told your mom.
Well, we thought we would give it a shot.
Yeah.
So we went to New York, and after 5 or 6 auditions, I got my fifth or sixth commercial.
Oh, so you did commercials.
Yeah, I did a whole bunch of commercials.
Yeah.
And then I got my first TV pilot.
Mm-hmm.
And that was called Scamps.
Yeah.
And then I got my second one, and that was called Little Shots.
Boy.
And then I got a movie, and then I got another movie. And then...
This youngster has a better career than I do.
Then I was on the Carson show.
Yeah.
And that's all I got on Give Me a Break.
Boy, I mean, how do you top that? What else is there?
I don't know.
Okay, I know there's tap dancing, though. And I want to learn to do the time step.
You do?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. I got a dance lesson this Saturday, but if I learn a little bit now, I'll be prepared, won't I? Okay, how do we do the time step?
Let's see how I'll teach this.
Better yet, why don't you do it?
Okay.
Huh? Music maestro, please. Oh, it kills me. I gotta do this. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Absolute minimum pricing. What does it mean? Potato chips, pretzels, and all bag snacks are 10% off every day at the new Giant Eagle.
If you were creating a wine for your own taste, you'd start with Concord grapes. You'd add rain, sunshine, and cool breezes at night. At the peak of ripeness, you'd press the grapes into a fragrant wine with a hint of sweetness. If you were creating your own wine, you'd create this wine. Cream White Concord from Manischewitz. We make wine with you in mind.
Hi, I'm Barry Bostwick, and believe it or not, I'll be playing George Washington in an 8-hour miniseries based on his life. Yes, believe it, because as the new TV guide makes clear, our first president was once young, athletic, he was full of passion for living and loving. Well, the TV guide tells you how we created this portrait of George Washington, truly our first American hero.
It's all inside the new TV guide.
An ounce of gold, an ounce of zinc. Which is more important for your good health? Zinc, more precious than gold for good health. Z-Bec is rich in zinc, a mineral essential to bones and red blood cells, plus 6 B-complex vitamins and vitamin C, vitamins your body can't store, plus vitamin E. To make sure you get enough zinc and vitamins in your diet, get Z-Bec, rich in zinc, more precious than gold for good health. Official vitamin of the 1984 United States Olympic team.
Here's your chance to score big with the Bucks. During all Pirate baseball games broadcast this season on KDKA-TV, three of you will get a chance to win in the Giant Eagle Home Run Sweepstakes. If one of our Bucks hits a home run in the inning your name is drawn, you win. Entry cards are available at all Giant Eagle supermarkets, or simply send a postcard to Giant Eagle Home Run Sweepstakes, Post Office Box 222, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 15230. It's your chance to play with the Pirates and come home a winner.
Loris Quartz. It's accurate, no wine, great looking. $9.95 to $54.95. Loris Quartz. It's everything except expensive.
MCI has rolled off these long-distance savings before, but maybe you didn't know that you can now use MCI's more modern system to call any other phone in any other state from coast to coast. And that it doesn't matter how few or how many calls you make, or at what hour you want to make them. Call MCI and join the millions of people who get their money's worth from their long-distance phone company.
Patty Burns and Ray Tannehill, tonight at 6.
What would you do if the company you or your husband worked for suddenly closed? Would you try to find another job? Or do what these workers did at a supermarket in Philadelphia. Watch. Marion DiGiacomo had worked as a checker at an A&P supermarket in suburban Philadelphia for almost 2 decades when word came that the store was closing. But Marion and her fellow workers took action to save their jobs. They decided to buy the store and run it themselves.
I worked at A&P for 17 years before we got the notice of a layoff. It didn't feel too good, I'll tell you, after working that many years at a store. After we were laid off, quite a few workers got together to see if we could start out with our own store.
And the A&P supermarket became the O&O, owned and operated by former employees.
It's like one big family, really. So we all help each other. In fact, we don't just work in our own department. If we have to help in other departments, we do that also. And I think it's like a challenge, more or less, and you really try to do your best in whatever you can.
I'm proud to be an owner. I feel like it's a worthwhile thing because
how much I work. I reap the benefits of things. And, you know, I really enjoy it.
There were 17 former A&P workers who bought the store. Each paid a $5,000 investment as a down payment, and meetings began to figure out how to run the business. Help was offered from a local business school, but all owners agree it hasn't been easy.
It's really tough. The responsibilities, you just have no idea what it's like to be in business. None of us have. And it's, me personally, it's been awesome. What you've had to learn, how you have to address just personal relationships, business relationships, professional relationships. It's awesome.
I can definitely see things that as a checker at a supermarket chain that I didn't see, because I see the other side of things now. Like double bagging and how much that costs. It's a 1% profit business. You can eat up all your profits just in double bagging and, you know, energy conscious things that I thought the supermarket chain I worked for was stingy in doing. I realize now they had a reason for doing those things.
After 2 years of operation, it's too early to tell if the O&O will make it, but customers can see a difference.
Their prices are, I find, much lower. They have good specials, and the people that work here are just fantastic. They really stand by their word. Everybody is just very congenial, and they go out of their way to please you.
I'll tell you, it's a little scary, really. Something that had never happened before in the supermarket business, and it was sort of a challenge, and we thought we'd make a try at it. And I think we're doing okay. Okay, have a nice day now. And I'll see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. It may be hard work, but it's obvious that it's worth the effort. We wish them the very, very best. Dr. William Rader and a woman who chose to have an ileostomy to save her life right after this.
You can taste rich, colorful, refreshingly white, cool, and creamy smooth as the land it comes from. It's the Dairy Queen Banana Split. Come taste the excitement.
In the land of Dairy Queen, it's a treat you get.
Look, it's not what you think.
What is it?
The all-in-one linen outlet is changing.
Only our name.
How come?
Haven't you noticed we've become more than just a linen outlet?
You mean bigger?
Bigger selection, more brand names, a complete drapery department.
And the bath stuff.
So we're changing our name to the Linen Center.
Linen Center.
It says big.
It says selection.
We like it.
But there's one thing we're not changing, our everyday outlet prices.
Good idea.
You're not losing the all-in-one linen outlet. You're gaining a Linen Center.
For the junior executive who's vowed to be a vice president by the end of the fiscal year. For the VP who's vowed to be a senior VP by the time she's 39. For the chairman who must ultimately face the shareholders. For all the things that success brings, the anxious upset stomachs that come with thumping heads, and thumping heads that come with anxious upset stomachs, there are the medicines of Alka-Seltzer. Alka-Seltzer. For the symptoms of stress that can come from success.
Why buy just a lawnmower when you can buy a Honda? And right now, you can save on the purchase of a Honda lawnmower during their area-wide open house. No matter how big or small your lawn is, Honda has the mower you need. Come in now and see the complete line of quality Honda power equipment. But don't wait. Honda's open house is over Saturday, April 7th. Honda lawnmowers are sold and serviced at...
See H&S Sales, Pantone Lawn and Garden, and Herring's Garden Center.
The word ostomy, it's a subject most of us feel uncomfortable discussing because it relates to an operation to aid people who have lost either bladder or bowel function. Dr. William Rader is back with an enlightening look at how this surgery is enabling people to lead normal lives. Ostomy is a suffix that's added to ileo or ileostomy or colostomy.
Right.
We've heard those words. What exactly is it?
Well, it's funny because I imagine a lot of people right now are probably, maybe, I hope not, walking up to turn off their sets. I don't want to hear this. And it's silly because what we're talking about is that, you know, the intestine is a tube. Also, the bladder has a tube that you can excrete urine through. And if it's diseased, either because of a birth defect or injured or, you know, cancer or some other disease, it doesn't work. The end of it doesn't work. So, or let's say the middle of it doesn't work. So what you need to do then is somehow bring it to the outside. Mm-hmm. So what they simply do is surgically just make a hole in the abdomen, then just cut off the diseased part, and then just bring it to the outside. And then there's a pouch that's disposable to either get the urine, which, you know, be ureostomy, or the colostomy, or the ileostomy, to get the fecal material out. Now, we all, you know, get so negative about those kinds of thoughts, but literally, when this is done, the person leads totally a normal life. What I'd like to show you, or what I'd like you to see, is a tape that I brought along. This is Marlene Vine, who has an ileostomy. She was told when she was 18 years old, that she had to have the surgery, and she had to have part of her bowel removed, as we just talked about, and brought to the outside of her abdominal wall.
I remember that day, my brother came to pick me up, and I remember running out to the car and crying and saying they're going to operate on me, and being, of course, very upset. Why is this happening to me? And because I have three brothers, and they weren't sick. I was the only one that had this. Again, I don't really want this to happen, but on the other hand, I'm tired of being sick. That was a big thing at that time, too. I was really tired of the whole thing. There was always, naturally, that how are people going to accept this? How am I going to be different? It's when I go out with somebody, am I going to... what's going to happen? Is this going to show? Is anybody going to know about this? And I remember the night before the surgery saying to myself that after this, I'm not going to be sick anymore. So there was a way to get out of the pain of being sick all the time and having...
That was very painful.
The disease, yes, very painful.
Are you talking physically?
Physically, yeah.
What about emotionally?
Emotionally, too, it runs your life. My life improved so much after the surgery, because that's when I really realized how sick I was and what was happening to me before was after. Because then I could do so many things that I couldn't possibly have done before, and of course I looked so much better.
Some people have actually made the choice to die rather than have the surgery.
Well, see, that's hard for me to understand. I know, I have talked to people that feel that way, but your life is so much better. I can't, it's hard to explain unless you've been through something like this to know how much better. My life is really very normal. Our society has said from the time you change a baby's diaper, this is bad. It has a bad diaper, and you go through your whole life saying, this is bad, and now I have something that's really bad. And what are people going to think, and how am I going to, and it's, you have to get past all that and just to yourself and say, look at who is really important here. It's me that's important in my life and what I can do with it. And not because I happen to have this bag on right now. I mean, does that make me any different? Do I look any different to you? I mean, am I any different to you in any way just because of that? Well, you have to tell yourself that and get the right perspective as to where your life is and what's important. I mean, is it more important to lay in the hospital dying? Is that important? Is that what you want in your life? When here there is something that can be done? An ostomy is not a disease. That's the strange thing about it. I mean, here you're being told that, you know, this is something terrible. We're not even dealing with a disease. This is a cure to a disease.
Why are you willing to go on television in front of all these people and talk about this?
I think it's very important for people to know about something like this. You can't turn on a medical program and see it. They don't do it on the medical shows. And you can't see it anywhere. You can't hear about it anywhere. It's not discussed. So if you're an unfortunate person who has bladder cancer or rectal cancer or ulcerative colitis, something where it comes down to they're saying, hey, you have to have this done, you feel like I'm the only person in the world.
So it sounds like a very positive choice for you.
It was the only choice. It's beyond positive. This was the answer for me. And I think anybody in that kind of situation, it's the only thing to do.
She said a couple of things there that are very important. It was the only choice, and it was either this or I assume
she would have died.
Yeah, I think this is the most important thing to remember about what we're talking about. People are making the choice to die. People are dead now who made that choice. A lot of people, only because of the mental set. Mm-hmm. This bag is totally sealed. Totally sealed. There's no odor, there's no nothing. And after a while, I mean, you don't even pay attention to it. And people are saying, I'd rather die, and they die. A lot of it comes from what others are going to say or feel. Yes. You can be totally sexual. I mean, it really has nothing to do with anything other than how we see it. And I use this analogy a lot, but, you know, if we never saw a nose, for example, it's a pretty horrible thing. I mean, look at this thing. With these two holes here, little hair coming out every once in a while.
Gallagher has a funny routine about it. It's probably the worst place it could be, right over
right,
the
right,
mouth.
Right over you, exactly. Yes. But if you never saw one, and surgically we had to give you a nose,
yes.
Oh, my, it's worse than this, because this is hidden, yeah. And this thing sticks out. But because we're used to it, we feel differently. Someone who wears this for a period of time, I mean, it's like anything else.
I do know that they're experimenting and have implanted some bags underneath the skin. Mm. The story is still out on that. I know a couple of football players actually are using them right now, which they're really putting them to the test. Mm-hmm. Hopefully that'll be the next stage. But in the interim, it's important that people know that there is a better life out there if you do suffer from ileitis, colitis, or...
Yeah, also colitis, some of these cancer, you can die from these diseases, and let's hope that someone watching who may have to make their choice in the future will make the choice to live, or at least try and see what it's like.
Yeah. Is she just unusual in her attitude toward it, or more and more?
No, I think that what happens is that people are shocked about what's going to happen. Talking to one of your guests before they came down, they were very nervous. What am I going to do? What's going to happen? You know, and the anticipation. I mean, they were just really very upset. And I said, you know what's going to happen? When you get off, you're going to say, oh, is that all there was? Mm-hmm. I want to do it again.
Yeah.
It's exactly what happened with her. And she didn't know what was going to happen. You don't know what's going to happen. So, no, it's not that unusual, because once it happens and you just do it, it becomes part of your routine and it doesn't mean anything to you.
Plus, you realize the quality of your life has been improved, which is terrific.
Tremendously so. Yeah. These diseases, many of them, you lose a tremendous amount of weight, you're sickly, you're weak, so your quality of life changes even physiologically.
If you'd like more information, you can write to the United Ostomy Foundation, 2001 West Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90057. Dr. Rader, thank you for being here with us today.
Thanks, Gary.
We'll be right back in a moment. Wait till you see who's getting a makeover with Jose Ibert. No one else but Heloise in just a moment.
This is an Eyewitness News Break.
Good afternoon. These are some of the stories we're working on for you in the Eyewitness Newsroom. A gas leak at the Wheeling Pit Steel Plant in Steubenville sends several area men to the hospital. Ralph Fiannotti has just returned from the scene. Also, who has the best chance of beating President Reagan in Pennsylvania? We'll have the results of an exclusive Eyewitness News Gallup poll. And a sobering warning to pregnant women tempted to drink just one. This and more coming up tonight at 6 o'clock.
The 84 Pirates swing into action Tuesday as they take on the San Diego Padres, and we're backing the Bucks all the way. Come cheer on the team with your friends from KDKA-TV at a very special Pirate Party 84. It'll be broadcast live from Froggy's in Pittsburgh. We'll take a close look at the 84 Pirate family and the new additions. Then catch the Pirates and the Padres live from San Diego. Don't forget, Pirate Party 84, followed by the Pirates and the Padres, all beginning Tuesday at 9. KD, you, and the Pirates. What a team.
Last time, America's top expert on household hints, Heloise, was with us. She attempted to tell us how to organize our lives. Now, here's a moment from that appearance, and this time I want you to pay very special attention to Heloise's hair.
I mean, life flows a lot easier if you're organized. Now, I'm not saying that you have to be perfect, because no one is perfect.
Yeah.
But nothing's worse than trying to find, you know, your mother's birthday, or remember your wife's birthday or her anniversary, and where is it, and you can't go ask her, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So you need to write these things down.
Yeah, but it comes down. Well, obviously her hair is one of her trademarks, but she decided it was time for a little change. So we called our hairstylist, Jose Ibert. He met Heloise, and in a moment, we're all going to see what happened. But in the meantime, would you welcome from Maurice Jose in Beverly Hills, Jose Ibert.
Hello.
You know, considering how her image is that hair, and she's not afraid or ashamed to admit it's gray. And that's the natural color.
That's the problem.
I would think she'd be nervous about changing it.
No, very nervous.
Yeah.
It took me a lot of convincing in order to really make her believe that she should change. She didn't want to change her color. But from what I hear, just before I came on here, next time she wants to try it. I mean, she needs a total makeover. Her image, she's stuck in this image, but I would suggest to change her totally, change the color and the cut.
Yeah,
I made it shorter.
You made it shorter.
Kept the same color, made it a little bit sexier, a little bit more sophisticated, and the next step would be the color, I would say.
All right, let's take a look at Heloise as she normally appears in the show. We took this shot earlier. There.
You see very long hair.
Look at that.
It's pretty hair, but it's not becoming for the face.
Uh-huh.
And the color, I mean, she's 30, over 30, 32, 33. It ages her. I mean, I wish she would change it. I think she's getting ready for it.
Now, we also have a shot of Heloise as she, in fashion, so to speak, as she appears on the show. Let's take a look at that.
That's the way she tries, a conservative image, but that's not the way she is. She's real crazy and wild, but she has to keep this image.
This is a woman that owns a big air balloon, a hot air balloon.
I know, but you're going to see her own personality. The real personality is real crazy, and
all
I
right.
like it.
Well, let's see, Miss Household Hints, Heloise. Ladies and gentlemen, Heloise. You didn't see Heloise back there, did you?
No, she's gone forever.
Gosh, what do you think?
I think it's fantastic.
What's David gonna think?
I hope he thinks the same thing, I'm sure.
It is so wild.
Isn't this wonderful?
Now, he said he'd like change the color.
Now, we're working on a step at a time.
Are you?
That you saw before, my hair was down to here.
Yeah.
It's been long all my life.
What a
difference.
And
I've worn it basically the same way. So this is probably the shortest it's ever been. So that's the first step.
Yeah.
Then maybe a little bit
later. Now to change the color, no?
Not right this minute.
Not
he wants to take
minute.
Me up there right now and do it. I know.
No. But little by little, I think she gets ready.
Yeah, I think maybe.
I mean, later. Was the fact that it's so identified with you, the gray, was that a big
consideration? That plus, I'm basically very lazy.
Yeah.
And the thought of having to go in every 2 to 3 weeks to get it re-dyed or touched up, I don't have time to do that.
Yeah.
It's all I can do to get in and go get it trimmed once every 6 weeks.
Well, you're a very busy woman with your career.
Well, really, it is. You know, so that's what is really mainly, I think, keeping me from doing it,
mm-hmm.
is if I could have Jose travel with me all the time and take care of it, then maybe
so. It's so glamorous.
Oh, I think
I
it's marvelous. Yeah. So maybe one of these days we'll see me with black hair.
Yeah.
Not black hair. I would like to see her in a chestnut brown. She would look 10 years younger.
Yes.
Than she
He's very worried about me looking all too old
now,
for my
Now, speaking
age.
Of step by step, he's worried about what?
He's very worried about me looking too old for my young age of 32.
She's 32. She's so young.
She's a
and
baby.
I think she, yeah, but she looks older than she is, I think.
Then that's sweet.
Not today.
Well, and the
Not
other
today.
Thing is, you know, she does, she's in the newspapers.
Yes.
And you sell books.
I sell books, and I have to look normally, you know, authoritative.
No, but I mean, you're not on television every day.
I'm not on television a lot.
Yeah.
And I think what really counts is what's inside and the way your family and friends...
Because you get into a rut, don't you?
Well, you do. And that's why I was thrilled about coming and having this done. Because the last time I was on the show, I had thought, you know, I'm tired of wearing my hair the same way
mm-hmm.
and my makeup the same way, and I'm just safe with it. It's comfortable. So I put myself in his hands,
right.
and this is... Of course, I was cringing a little bit while he was cutting it.
Oh, I'm sure you were. But is this going to be... Can she do this with all...
Oh,
what
yeah.
I mean, a set of hot rollers. I mean,
and
I cut it down to the shoulder, real blunt, slightly
mm-hmm.
laid the bottom, a set of hot rollers, brushed it out, and...
See, now that's what... Because I told him that it has to be something that I can do and that I can do in 5 minutes. I don't have the time to wake up every morning and do curlers and all that stuff.
Yeah, you never told me what color you would change the hair to.
Chestnut brown.
Chestnut.
Yeah.
Sounds like a horse's mane.
Huh?
Yes.
Whatever you want. Whatever you want, Heloise, it's yours with Jose. All right, let's take a look at Heloise before. And there's Heloise after. My gosh. Terrific, Jose, Heloise. We'll be right back.
How much faster can one antacid be than another? 3 times? 4 times? 10 times? Meet new stronger formula Riopan Plus. Sodium-free, made to neutralize more acid. In laboratory tests, it starts to neutralize acid in seconds. 10 times faster than the 2 leading liquids.
10 times faster.
It's long-lasting.
And Riopan Plus is sodium-free. No wonder it's doctor-recommended.
In lab tests, works faster. Long-lasting Riopan Plus.
You've used it for years. Your family's used it. Now there's another reason to use it. It fights plaque. It's Listerine antiseptic. Recent clinical tests prove that Listerine kills the germs that cause plaque, a germ film that forms on your teeth. And yes, it still kills the germs that cause bad breath. Rinsing with Listerine, in addition to regular brushing, reduces plaque by up to 50% over brushing alone. Listerine fights plaque for better oral hygiene. It's in your bathroom cabinet. Use it.
Why not put Pillsbury slice and bake cookies and ice cream together and make cookie ice cream arounds?
Oh, that poppin' fresh dough.
You just bake up the cookies, let them cool, then pile on the ice cream.
Ice cream in between, cookies and ice cream. Oh,
everyone likes Pillsbury cookie ice cream arounds.
Poppin' fresh dough.
Now there's a brand new soap that's twice as effective as the number one deodorant soap, Dial. Two times better because it has an exclusive formula that's two times more effective at killing odor-causing bacteria. To give you the most advanced deodorant protection you can get and all the confidence you want. What is this extraordinary new soap? The best Dial ever. And aren't you glad?
The new Heloise, or the semi-new Heloise, and Jose Ebert, because they're saying they're going to, I guess, progressively change
this. Which, yeah. I think is what a lot of women go through, is that you start with long hair, and then maybe you get cut here, and then maybe here, and then you'll do the color in a different style. Uh-huh. You know, it's not quite so such a shock to the system.
Yeah, now you said chestnut brown for her, but what about most women with gray hair? You advise to advise them?
I advise most women to change the hair color, because a lot of times, I mean, no matter what, gray hair always going to age a woman.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So basically, I would say get rid of the gray hair. But sometimes, once in a while, you see a woman with white hair looking stunning.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Very stunning.
Could be very stunning. So I would say, okay, keep it. But I mean, it's just once in a while. The potential is so low.
Are there products on the market that enhance gray hair?
No, sometimes you have a lot of rinses who would take the yellow. A lot of times, white gray hair has a tendency of having kind of yellow, mm-hmm. kind of
a yellow tint to it.
To it. So yeah, a lot of times you can have silver rinse and take the yellow out, but. Yeah.
When did this start, the gray?
When I was 12 years old.
And your mother, was your mother also
gray?
Well,
what's ironic is that my mother was not premature gray. And when she went to start the Hints from Heloise column, she was 39 years old. She didn't think she looked old enough. So she took silver hairspray and sprayed the front of her hair and ran a comb through it so she would look older and more distinguished.
Well, I look forward to the progressive change in Heloise.
We
can be assured you're
going to
be back. Thank you both.
Yeah, thank you.
That closes another edition of our magazine. A big thank you to all my guests. Till tomorrow, Gary Collins, Jose Ebert, and Miss Heloise, reminding you to make every hour count. Bye-bye.
Only Arid has this baby fresh scent.
Tough on wetness and odor.
But, baby fresh on you.
Arid Baby Fresh Spray, roll-on solid, and baby fresh cream.
Our Lazy Boy recliner has over 50 years of craftsmanship built into it.
That's such a comforting thought.
Mm-hmm.
Lazy Boy, because it was the first and still is.
Helpful, even-flow products include glass, plastic, and disposable bottles, nursing supplies, playthings, teething, feeding, and nursery accessories. Even-flow, a friend of the family.
Care Bears Play Gym from Headstrong. The fun and action of a play gym with all the quality you expect from Headstrong. Niagara is America's number one selling spray starch. It keeps clothes cleaner and fresher looking longer. It helps prevent the deep penetration of soil and stains. You get a crisper, firmer finish with Niagara Spray Starch.
WD-40 makes it easy to clean and do repairs all around the house. Discover new ways to use it. Look for this display in free brochures at participating stores. Furnished by WD-40.
Listen, if you're coming to Los Angeles, I'd love to meet you in person. Please write for audience tickets to Our Magazine, Tickets, 5800 Sunset Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90028. See ya.
Here, the Fruits of Spring, the University of Pittsburgh, presents its Spring Student Recital on April 3rd at 8:30 p.m. in the Frick Fine Arts Building Auditorium.
Gary Collins and Bonnie Strauss's Wardrobes, furnished by Henry Grethel.